I thank God to be with you today. Last Sunday I was not able to be with you because I went to pastor another place. Bwana asifiwe. So that's why I could not be with you. But today I'm with you. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Brother Tony told us pastors to ask washiriki walikujaje hapa. So nataka niulize mlikujaje. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I'm surprised because I'm really surprised because one day in this the week ending yesterday, we are in the new week. It's the first day of the week. So one of the days in the week ending, nilikuwa kazini nikifanya kazi yangu ile mnajua. Kazi ya kuongea. Piga kelele. So katika harakati zangu za kuongea, niliingia. Nianze kuongea. When I opened my mouth to start talking, I don't know what happened. The spirit took over the mouth. And I started singing in tongues. When we speak in tongues, we speak mysteries. We speak what? Mysteries. Vitu ambavyo mtu haelewi. But you, the speaker, and your spirit, you understand what actually you are saying. So I found myself singing in tongues. Went around the class singing in tongues. The total aneurysm. Until we can't understand what you are saying, but I was lost somehow. But I was natural. Bwana asifiwe. I could still see this is a chair. Naenda kando. It's a desk. Naweza jigonga na napita kando. But taken over in the spirit. Then I had a voice say, "A rolling stone gathers no moss." That's a proverb in English. Eh? A rolling stone gathers no moss. Then another voice asked a question. Why does so and so keep moving from one church to another? And then a name was given to me specifically. I'll not tell you the name. Bwana asifiwe. I'll not give you the name. So don't ask me the name because I'm not telling. Limebanwa. Jina limefanyaje? Limebanwa. Why does he keep moving from one church to another? And then the same voice said, he will end up in hell. No, huyu ni mtu napenda sana. But now these are the words coming from heaven. You know, a rolling stone, ni yule mtu, ni metali inamaanisha mtu ambaye hana makao. Anabadilisha kila mara hapa. Kama ni mtu, kama ni kazi, anabadilisha kazi, anapata hii, anabadilisha tu kazi. Sio kwamba anatafuta kazi. Hapana. Ni mtu ana kazi na ana bahati ya kupata kazi. Lakini, kipata hii, anawaja. Chukwaya, anawaja. Chukwaya, anawaja. Eventually, kulingana hiyo methali, this person can never be trusted with responsibility. Person cannot be trusted with the responsibility at all. I met a man of God, who akipewa tu a responsibility in the church, anavuruga, alafu anatoroka. Akisha toroka, ameenda nasema nilipigwa vita. Sikia nikutoma Tony akiongea hapa kupigwa vita. That's one thing I thank God. I've never said nilipigwa vita na mtu. Si kwamba vita si kupigwa, but it never occurred on my lips. And may I tell you, if people can never speak ill about you, then you are dead. You are not alive. Bwana asifiwe. Only the dead are praised. True or false? Mtu hata kama alikuwa mwizi, akishakufa alikuwa mpole, alikuwa hakuwa na kanyaga hata inzi. That's true. But the living people, the people who are alive, someone must speak ill about you. So watu wakiongea vibaya kuhusu, jua kwamba uko hai. Hujakufa. Bwana asifiwe. And that's one thing God taught me, and I know beyond doubt that as long as I live, the majority will speak ill about me. That I know, and God helped me to prepare for it, even as He brought me into the ministry. So, when Brother Tony is speaking here, and then all these things that were happening during the week comes back to my mind, very fresh to my mind, then I realize for sure, a rolling stone gathers no moss. God can never trust such people with responsibility. Never. And eventually, these people are going to end in hell. So that word spoke to me. This man will end up in hell. It was a very touching word to my spirit. And I wished I could help. But wahenga walisema, udongo uwai, gari mbichi. You can only correct a child. You can correct a spiritual child. At mtu akisha mature spiritually, sometimes it is a big challenge to correct that person. Especially mtu akifika level ya kusema, God said to me, God told me. They become what we call old prophets. The old prophet prophesied a lie to the young prophet. The young prophet was destroyed. God was annoyed with the young prophet because he listened to the old prophet, and God destroyed the young prophet. That's why I usually say, as long as you live, allow yourself to be corrected. Allow yourself to be rebuked. Kubali ukemewe. Kubali uambiwe hii ni makosa na urekebishe. God will trust you. God will love you. But when you become rigid, you cannot be corrected. You are perfect. Then you are on your way to destruction. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana apewe sifa. in the process again, you know, vitu ambavyo Tony amezungumza hapa, ninashangaa, but I thank God because imetokea kwake. Kwa nikisimama niseme, nasema huyu jamaa anajitetea. But the one that was speaking to me also warned about speaking against pastors. May I tell you, pastors are not angels. They are human beings. They have their own weaknesses, all right? I, standing before you, I have my weakness, a very bad weakness. Only my wife knows. Because she's very close to me every minute. So she knows how weak I am. And my weakness, she understands very well. I'm very weak. But God comes in and becomes strength in my weakness. And that's when I can stand before you. Please make sure the word pastor is not so much on your lips in the negative. Siongee juu ya wachungaji. Na sio tu wachungaji hapa kanisani hili. Mchungaji anywhere in the world. Don't form a habit of talking against them every time. You may inherit a curse. Kama amekosea, leave that person in the hands of God. As long as that person is anointed as a minister of the gospel, leave them alone. Don't talk negatively about them. Leave them alone. Because that's how people have inherited curses without their knowledge. So church, be one. That's why we thank God, because God is correcting us. Even me as a person, I'm being corrected. So, the words that have been spoken on this pulpit are true and amen. And I want to confirm, there are words that the Lord spoke to me during the week. Mimi naingia kwa Raza Fundisha, when I open my mouth and Isalmia wanafunzi wangu, I start singing in tongues. And then the Lord starts speaking to me. Well, the Lord does not take long to talk to us. Within a second, He has said volumes, things you can write 100 pages. Within a second, He has spoken very many things to you. So, I want to urge us to be vigilant. To be what? To be vigilant. To be very, very vigilant with our lips and what we say and what we do. Would you like God to give you a responsibility? Please hold on. The words that have been said on these pulpits, the Lord was speaking to your heart. And part of these words were in my sermon today. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
You remember the talents? The talents. Kumbuka wale watu walipewa talents na hiyo ni inaitwa parable. Kiswahili kinaitwaje parable? Mfano, mafungu. Yesu akatoa mfano. Akasema, tajiri mmoja akatoka naenda safari. Akapatia mmoja watumishi wake talanta ngapi? How many talents? 10 talents. To another one he gave? 5. To another one he gave? 1. Then we were 10 talents, akaenda kafanyia biashara, akaleta. Watano akaenda kafanyia biashara, akapata faida. When the mkubwa came, akaitisha aletewe talanta zake. Then the one with the 10 brought another. Are they 10 talents? No, they were 5 talents. Akaleta 10 talents. Alipewa 5, akaleta 10. Mwingine akapewa 2, akaleta 4. Mwingine akapewa 1, akaenda kazika. Kaenda kafanya nini? Akazika. Sawa, wengine wamefanyia biashara talanta zao, wakaleta faida kwa mkubwa. Watu wa moja akaamua, huyu, this man is a very hard man. In fact, in the scripture inasema, I knew you are a hard man. You reap where you never planted. You gather where you never scattered. So I went and hid your talent. And the master was annoyed with him. So what does this mean? The talents are those gifts we are given. Ukienda neno talent, talent is a word, is a unit of measure, a unit of money. So wakisema alipewa 5 talents, he was given a unit of money. Aenda fanyie biashara, arudishe faida. That was the desire of the master. These talents are the giftings people have in the church. The giftings we have in the church. Those are the talents. Now, when you are given a gift, then you serve God in the gift. Ukisoma maandiko pale, utapata katika Matthew chapter 25, ukisoma utapata. Ukisoma maandiko pale, Yesu anasema kwamba, huyu bwana aliporudi, akaitisha aliyepewa 5, akaleta talanta 10, akasema bwana ulinipatia 5, nikaenda nikafanya faida, biashara nikapata faida ya 5, nimeleta talanta 10. Bwana akamuita, blessed are you, you are faithful. So the word faithful in that scripture is used. You are faithful with few. Now God will give you 10 cities to man. Go and inherit the kingdom of your father. Yule alipewa 2, akaleta zake, kamwambia faithful servant. So what is required in the service of God, the gifts you have, is that faithfulness. That faithfulness. That's what God wants in your life. Are you faithful in the gifts? Now, as a child of God, you must find something in the church to do. All of us cannot be pastors. Is it possible? We cannot all be pastors. There must be evangelists. There must be prophets. There must be apostles, there must be teachers, there must be administrators in a ministry. There must be there. So each person must identify, you must identify what you are given. What is the area of operation in that church? And operate in that area faithfully. That's what God is looking for. You operate in that area faithfully. Unanisikia vizuri? Yes, when I insist in neno pale, faithful servant. You are faithful with the 5 talents. Faithfulness. When we don't use the gifts we are given, some of us, they may not be gifts, they may be talents. Talents, the word talent can also mean natural abilities someone is born with. Natural abilities. Those natural abilities may be planted in your life by God. So they are not necessarily gifts of the Holy Spirit. They are just natural abilities. For example, someone is a good artist. Can just look at you and draw you the way you are. That is a talent. It's not a gift. It's a talent. A natural ability. Now, if you have those talents, you use them for the glory of God. You are a faithful servant. Buenas, si fibre.
Amen.
These are areas God is looking at in a child, in his child's life. So if we are children of God, God is looking at how faithful we are. Are we faithful in what we do? If you are given a responsibility by God, how do you carry out that responsibility? God is looking at it. Now, this man here, akasema, Master, I knew you are a hard man. So what did I do? I decided to bury your talent. Kaizika, kaificha. So that when you come, I give you your talent. Because you are a man who gathers where you don't scatter. You are a man who reaps where you never sowed. Then the master was annoyed with that servant. And he called him unfaithful, ungrateful. Then he ordered his servants to bind him and cast him into the abyss where there is suffering in the fires of hell and gnashing of teeth. Gnashing of teeth. And you are gnashing of teeth. So Eric Nasamai.
Saga man.
Saga man. Saga man. I slept in a hotel somewhere. Koko Mombasa. Slept with another gentleman in a hotel room. And the whole thing he did the whole night was gnashing teeth. Saga man the whole night. Amelana fofofo. Lakini na saga man kweli kweli. Nasikia tu kiakilia. And the first time I woke up, nikaenda kuangalia what is happening. Wale jamaa ko sound asleep. Nenda kabisa. But man, mwakusikia uchungu mpaka ukauma meno. Ikateleza juu ya ingine. Katoa sauti. Yani, that is the kind of pain these people are going to experience. Katika moto wa milele. I pray that none of us here will be part of it. Bwana asifiwe. So from today, we want to straighten our paths, all right? We have to straighten our paths. Because God has spoken. I want to tell you again, a rolling stone gathers no moss. He will never trust you with the responsibility. So you must stand firm and declare your stand. Say, Lord, I stand here today. I declare my foot will not move from this place unless by your command. Unless by your command. By God's command. Bwana asifiwe. That is for people who have a purpose in life. No, kuna watu wengine hawana purpose in life. Wanaishi tu kwa sababu watu wanaishi. Najua marehemu mama yangu alikuwa anasema watu wengine wanazaa tu kwa sababu panya wanazaa. Watu wengine wanaishi kwa sababu watu wanaishi. They have no purpose in life at all. Hawajui, they just live. And that's why they live carelessly. They don't care. They have no purpose in life. We are living because people live. The next minute I'm dead because people die. But as for me, I have a purpose. I have a purpose. There's a place I want to go after here. After here, there's a place I want to go. I don't know if you are to go anywhere after here. Do you have a purpose really? People who have a purpose in life have to be very careful how they live. And they have to make sure that they are obeying every instruction the Lord gives. They obey. They want to follow it strictly. Because I don't want to be found offside of God. Don't want to be found off guard. I want when the trumpet sounds in the skies, I will be my ears open. My ears will be open, and I'll hear the trumpet sound, and I'll be ready to meet the Lord in the skies. Well, as if you will.
Amen.
No. Someone had me singing. They are just the week early. Someone had me singing it. Again, I don't know why it came the tongue too much this week. Again, I was walking on the corridor singing in tongues. Walking on the corridor singing in tongues. And they said, I didn't know someone was following me from behind. And he asked me, and then why are you singing? And you are singing in a language that people can't understand. And I told the man, I'm trying to be ready, you know. The Lord can come any minute now. Then he asked me, you are so confident with your Lord. I said, yes. Can he promise he will come? He can come any minute now. I'm trying to be ready. Well, as if you will. That is to say, the child of God must live ever ready. Ever ready. Because the time and the hour, no one knows. Even the Son himself said, I do not know except the Father. So the Father knows the time. Any minute he can command the Son, now it's time, go. And the Son will obey the Father. And he'll do what? He'll come. And finds you offside. That's why I say, be ready, be watchful, be alert every time. Be alert. Because the time you think the Son of Man is not coming, that's when he comes. But as if you will. Look at the 10 virgins. You look at the 10 virgins? See, they were waiting for the bridegroom. Then it seemed like the bridegroom was late. And they all dozed off and slept. What 10 virgins. But the difference is here. That at midnight, there was a call that the bridegroom had arrived. So the difference here is 5 of the virgins had their spare oil, while the other 5 did not have any oil. So their lamps were dying off. They were told to go to the shops to buy. And the moment they were going to the shops to buy, the bridegroom had arrived, and the 5 who had their lamps on entered with the bridegroom, and the doors were closed. Now these ones who went to buy them, paraffin, the oils, came later and found the door closed. When they called, the bridegroom said, I do not know you. I do not know you. I pray that we shall not be part of those people that the Lord will tell, I did not know you. Because of the stupid things we did on earth. So as you live today, he has given you an opportunity. That's why he's spoken to us the way he's spoken. He has given us an opportunity to put straight our paths. To correct where we went wrong. Make sure you put straight your path. Buona sifiwe. Buona pio sifa. I'm not preaching. I'm only strengthening what the Lord has spoken to us. Because I believe this thing, God has spoken with a purpose to correct somebody. Remember, God does not just speak in an empty space. He has a reason why he's saying what he's saying. Maybe even one person in the whole congregation. Maybe two. Maybe all the people. But God does not just say, and he does not send his word in vanity. That word has a reason. So from today, I want to say, we are going to watch our steps. Vita lazima upigwe. Nasikia vizuri? Hata mimi nitapiga vita. Right? Be ready for it. Nitapiga vita. That I have to assure you. Na nataka kupigwa vita na mimi. And you are in the wrong place. Na nitapiga vita. Bwana asifiwe. There's something I'll come to tell you, this is wrong, and you'll feel that Mr. Ujamaa. Because you love it so much, you'll not want to part from it. But I'll speak about it repeatedly. You'll feel this man hates me. That's not like me. Hata kuna tabia zingine ziko ndani ya watu. People parting with those habits ni ngumu sana. Yaani naona hiyo tabia. Kuna katabia kamoja kamekataa kutoka. Niulize ni gani?
Gani?
Uongo. Yuko mtu hapa nikimuuliza this month is October. This month ujawahi ujasema huo. Kuna mtu hapa ataniambia ajasema huo. Haka nikatabia kamekataa kutoka. But you know it's very dangerous. It can lead us to hell. So wakati nitagongelea hiyo uongo. Ndugu yangu uongo. Uongo toa. You'll feel like I'm fighting you. You'll feel like I don't love you. So my good friend, be ready for war, right? Uwe tayari kupigwa ni vita. Nikipigwa vita, mimi huwa nasema hivi. Persistence wears out resistance. So when I was opposed in preaching, when I started preaching and I faced a stiff opposition. Stiff opposition. Nyinyi mna hakuna kitu mnaona nyinyi. Yaani mwae kuhubiri mpaka ukapigwa. Unaambiwa unyamaze. Unapigwa kabisa unyamaze. Wewe mwae pitia hiyo kweli. Mkipita mnarushiwa mawe. Watu wanafanya group in the village. Na room wanakungoja. Ukija unakuja kupita wanagawana. Wengine upande huu, wengine huku. Sota upite katikati yao. Ushtukie tu amekuvumania. Virurungu kabisa. Then as you reach them, God mesmerizes them. Wanakuwa held captive. Unapita. Kisha pita ndio wanaanza kurusha matusi. Hamjaona kitu. Kuna kitu mmeona. So don't tell us that unapigwa vita. Wewe hujapigwa vita. Napigwa vita vya maneno na vya roho. Hapo ndipo Yesu Paul anauliza katika maandiko. Korintho anasema hivi, nyinyi hamjawahi pigana na dhambi hata kumwaga damu. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I want you to, from today, after hearing this message, let us put our paths how? Straight. If there is anywhere we made a mistake, we went wrong, let us tell God to forgive us. Let us tell God to do what? Forgive us. Lord, forgive us and let us start afresh. You know, in the prophecy to my Abiwa, go back. So that I can imagine it, go back. Now, as a pastor, I'm saying God gives us a new beginning. God can give us a what? A new beginning. If you do what? If you repent. God, you may tell God, for sure I messed here. I blame the Pastor Tom. Nikasema ABCT kus Pastor Tom. Father, forgive me. Forgive me and give me a new beginning. And now that you have been warned, never repeat. Bwana asifiwe. Never do what? Because Mungu ataona sasa wewe ni mtu wa mchezo. So now umekuwa mtu wa mchezo, all right? I hold you responsible. Bwana asifiwe. I've said it repeatedly here. Don't joke with the grace. We shall go to heaven by grace. We are saved by grace. It is not your effort. It is not your power. It is by the grace of God. But don't play with that grace. It may be worse than the law. Because in the grace, tunafanya tu makusudi, tunaenda zetu, then nothing happens, tunasema sawa. I'm saved by the grace. I live by the grace. Sawa. Live by the grace. But there are rules that govern that grace. So let us obey the rules that govern the grace of God. Bwana asifiwe. And with those words I want to say, God bless you. Amen. When we were praying, and I said when a prophecy comes, did I say it the previous Sunday? When a prophecy comes, it invites warfare. A prophecy comes, it invites warfare. So when we are praying the morning, this church, we were praying the morning seriously. We were praying seriously. And I heard this words. I heard this word. Wanaita Farao or Pharaoh? Ingereza kinaita Pharaoh. Now people pronounce words differently. Swahili ni Farao, sio? Swahili ni kwa fadhai. Swahili naita Farao, najua tu ni Farao. Hii Kiingereza kina different pronunciations. Ni Pharaoh, ingine nikasikia ameita Pharaoh. Okay. So Pharaoh, let's say Pharaoh. Because the voice that spoke in English. I said Pharaoh will kneel. Does that make sense to you?
Yes.
Pharaoh will kneel. Does it make sense to you?
Yes.
Hey, you respond like people who just...
Yes.
It means nothing. It's no more. You know, Pharaoh was the king of Egypt when the Israelites were captives in Egypt. And this man refused to let the children of Israel go free when God sent Moses to deliver them. He refused to let the children of Israel go. Then God decided to send plagues. How many plagues was it?
10.
Well, according to other schools of theology, there were 10 plagues. But according to my school of theology, there were 11 plagues. And the last one was devastating. That made Pharaoh kneel. Even when his son died, he never knelt. He only mourned. And that touched his heart and he let the Israelites to go. But after he recovered from the grief, the loss of his son, he assembled his army and decided to follow the Israelites and bring them back. Right? Then the whole of his army, Katok, Pamagari, Nafarasi, Wanafukuza, Wawashiki. And the children of Israel saw it. And they were scared. They started crying to Moses. Moses turned to them and said, "The Egyptians you see today, you shall never see them again." Amen. And then God said to Moses, "Stop crying to me. What do you have in your hand? Tell the children of Israel to stand firm." Then Moses says, "I have a staff in my hand." Then God said to him, "Stretch it over the Red Sea." Then Moses stretched it over the Red Sea, and what happened? The winds of the east, the winds of the west blew the water. And the water was separated, and a dry path was formed at the base of the sea. And the children of Israel crossed. And when the Egyptian army saw the children of Israel crossing, now wakafuat, Pharaoh akawambia, "Follow them!" Something strange. Pharaoh was leading the army. Sasa kasimama kwa ufuo. Now I see that was God telling him, "Stand there. I want you to see what I'm going to do to your army." Because if he was dead in the water, we would not get this account. Then the whole army into the sea. Now the children of Israel have crossed to the other side. Now what does God say? Mungu anangoja tu waingie wote. Anangoja tu. Again, you fools. I know I want to show how strong my hand is. Then when they were all in the water, God told Moses, "Stretch your hand over the water." And Moses stretched his staff over the water, and the sea came back. And all the horses, the chariots, and the soldiers were drowned in the sea. They all died. And Pharaoh saw it, and he fell on his knees. Buenas ifiwe. He fell on his knees. Kajua, he was fighting a God I cannot defeat. Fighting a God I cannot defeat. He realized that he was fighting a God he cannot beat. After his army was swallowed by the sea, that's when he realized he was fighting a God he could not fight. That even after his son died, aliambia watu wake, "Eh? We have gone through the 10 plagues and we have survived. So let's go and bring them back." But then he was given the last blow, the hardest one, for a king. Kuwa disarmed. He was disarmed. Bwana asifiwe. So when God says, the Pharaoh will kneel. What does that mean to you? When the children of Israel saw the army of Egypt drowned, Miriam composed a song on the other side of the sea. She composed a song and sang a song of victory. When Pharaoh kneels, it means your battles with Pharaoh are over.
Amen. Amen.
You'll never see him again.
Amen.
So there's a victory awaiting us. It's a victory.
Amen.
I told you, whenever there's a prophecy, it's warfare. So don't take prophecies lightly. They fail to be fulfilled because we take them lightly. After the prophecies are not fulfilled, then tunasema the prophet was a false prophet. Then tunakwote maandiko inasema nini? It is in the book of Jeremiah. Inasema? Jeremiah 28. Inasema? A prophet shall be known to be a true prophet if what he said comes to pass. So to relate na hiyo, tunasema, this prophet who prophesied to us was not a true prophet. I want to say, every prophecy invites warfare. Because the enemy is there to fight and make sure the prophecy is not fulfilled. So we have to go to warfare and make sure our prophecies are fulfilled and make sure Pharaoh amepiga magoti. Bwana asifiwe. And as the voice was speaking to me, I could see the collapse. I could see the collapse of the Pharaoh. I could see the collapse of faith. In the spiritual, with the spiritual eyes, I could see his collapse. So God wants to collapse some people. Hello, I am already kufa.
Amen.
Amen. Buenas y fieles.
Amen.
Whatever they are, wasikie sauti.
Amen.
Wawe tayari kufa. Buenas y fieles.
Amen.
Now, but tusimame sote. We make our last prayer. You want to go before the Lord. One thing you have said, to make our path straight. Whatever we've gone wrong in our deeds, in our words, let us ask God to forgive us and give us a new beginning. And from then we shall walk straight in God's presence. But two, we want the Pharaoh to kneel, listen. Then we shall sing a song of victory.
Amen.
We shall praise the Lord everywhere we go because of the victory he'll have given us.
Thank you. Father, we thank you this afternoon. We thank you because, Lord, you care for us. You loved us from the beginning that we may be your people. We commit our lives in your hands today. Father, we are standing before you. We humble ourselves before you. Lord, we repent our trespasses. We repent our wickedness, Lord. Whatever we've done that does not please you, Lord, we ask you to sanctify us. Lord, we ask you, Lord Jesus, we have uttered evil words with our lips, even against your servants, Lord. We ask you to forgive us, Lord. We ask you to sanctify us, Lord Jesus Christ, and give us a renewed beginning, Lord, that Lord Jesus may walk in the paths of righteousness and glorify you now and forever, because you are our Father. We thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you because you are going to speak to us. We thank you because, Lord Jesus, you are going to guide us. You are going to show us the way. You are going to lead us in the way. In the way, Lord Jesus Christ, with your strong hand, Lord, you are going to lead us, Lord. You are going to show us, Lord Jesus. We thank you and we bless you. Thank you for this day, oh dear Lord Jesus Christ. We pray that, Father, in the name of Jesus, you will speak to our lives. You will speak to our minds. You will speak to our thoughts. Lord Jesus, you are glorified. Thank you, Father. Bless us now, Lord. We pray that, Lord Jesus, whoever has been rising up against us, Lord Jesus, today we declare that they will kneel on their knees, Lord, and realize that there's a God in our midst, Lord. We pray today, King of Kings and Lord of Lords, may the mighty hand of the Lord Jesus Christ come upon our lives, Lord. Let the Pharaoh kneel. Let the Pharaoh kneel, Lord. Come on. Let the Pharaoh kneel. Father, I pray today in the name of Jesus. You've spoken to us that the Pharaoh will kneel. And we command that the Pharaoh must kneel. The Pharaoh must kneel. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the Christ. And Lord Jesus, we pray that we shall walk victoriously. We shall sing songs of victory. Because God has given us victory. We thank you and we bless you, Lord. Thank you, mighty Father. We bless you, Lord. As we part from now, Lord Jesus, we pray that our homes shall be blessed. Whatever we put our hands to do will be blessed. Yes. Lord, we shall sing praises unto you. Yes. Because you are our Father. Yes. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
May the grace
of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forever.
Amen. God bless you.